Leviathan here. A question that people ask a lot, both in real life and the comments down below, is do I miss the Ferrari F430, forever known as the Lamborghini Mustang? So today I'm gonna talk about the five things I miss most about the Ferrari F430. Let's go for a drive. Look, before I begin, I don't want you to take this the wrong way. It's by no means at the expense of the McLaren 650S. In fact, this is the best car I've ever driven in my entire life. But it has one critical flaw, and that's me. I just don't feel like I belong in a McLaren. Look, I don't know if that makes any sense, but I kind of feel like you have to be famous, special, or important to drive around in a McLaren, and I'm none of those three things. I'm just a car guy with an illogical obsession with supercars. Well, that's a topic in and of itself, so let's get back to the five things I miss most. Oh shit. Bentley. Number one, the soundtrack. Look, the Ferrari F430 sounds incredible at every single RPM. You could be stuck at a traffic light and the idle will make your heart race. You could be revving it through the gears responsibly, and that's just music to the ears. The McLaren, however, is slightly different. It only really sounds incredible at higher RPMs, even with the sport exhaust. That's, again, the personality of the McLaren, but I can't help but miss that soundtrack. Number two, the racing motifs. Look, in a Ferrari, you're constantly reminded of the racing pedigree. When you look at the rearview mirror, you see the engine, the heart of the car, pulsate. When you look at the side mirrors, you see those massive intake scoops. Inside the car, you see these medallions of success and victory, but you don't really see that in a McLaren. When I look at the rearview mirror, it's obviously a spider, so I can't see the engine. When I look at my side mirror, I see a lot of carbon fiber. Inside, you see the Alcantara, which gives you that racy element, but it's by no means similar to the Ferrari. There is one car that the McLaren has that trumps the Ferrari. When you brake this car really hard, the rear spoiler flies up so you can't see anything. And you know you're driving your car hard, and each time I see the spoiler go up, it puts a smile on my face. Number three, depreciation. So the Ferrari is an old car, and in the past 12 years, it's realized a majority of its depreciation. So you can really drive that car and not have to constantly look at the mileage. You can really drive that car without a care in the world, knowing that your Ferrari is not gonna depreciate, and you can almost sell it for pretty much exactly what you paid for. However, the McLaren is obviously a newer car, and it's a lot more sensitive to depreciation. Every mileage is definitely gonna cost you. A lot of people like to joke that the one thing faster than the speed of light is depreciation on a McLaren. Number four, the simplicity of the Ferrari. You don't have that fancy, expensive carbon fiber trim everywhere. In the interior, it's a lot more basic, it's a lot more raw. And most of all, the components of the car is a lot more simpler relative to the McLaren. I'm not saying that the Ferrari is a simple car, but given its history, the problems that develop are a lot more easier to diagnose. For example, in the McLaren, it took 2 weeks for McLaren just to figure out what was wrong with the car. 2 weeks. The McLaren is far superior when it comes to performance over the Ferrari. And to achieve this level of performance, the car is significantly more complicated. But again, that has its drawbacks as well. And finally, number five, the personality of the Ferrari. Look, that's an old car and it knows it's not the quickest or the shiniest or the fastest compared to the newer generation supercars, but it can still throw a serious blow when it wants to, kind of like Rocky. And that's actually one of the things I really love about the Ferrari. It doesn't take itself too seriously and it still belongs in the supercar community. And the McLaren, on the other hand, is a very serious supercar in every single respect. The performance, the doors, the looks, everything about it is very serious. But it's not just about performance when it comes to a supercar, it also comes to that driving pleasure and driving soul. We had a lot of great experiences in the Ferrari F430, and I'm really looking forward to having a lot more new experiences in the McLaren 650S. So guys, thanks for watching, and until next time, take care.